కేంద్ర మంత్రి పదవులకు సుజనా చౌదరి, అశోక్ గజపతిరాజు రాజీనామాలు సమర్పించారు. ఈ పరిణామాలపై చర్చించేందుకు సీఎం చంద్రబాబు అందుబాటులో ఉన్న మంత్రులతో సమావేశమయ్యారు. మీటింగ్ అనంతరం మంత్రి కాల్వ శ్రీనివాసులు మాట్లాడుతున్నారు. ఆ లైవ్ చూద్దాం.
నరేంద్ర మోడీ గారు గుజరాత్ ముఖ్యమంత్రిగా ఉన్నప్పుడు కేంద్రంలో వేరే ప్రభుత్వం ఉండిండొచ్చు, కానీ కేంద్రం రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వాల మధ్య సంబంధాలు ఉంటాయి. ప్రభుత్వాల మధ్య ఆ రకంగా మాకు రావాల్సిన సహాయాన్ని మేము రాబట్టుకోవడానికి అనేక రకాలుగా ప్రయత్నాలు చేస్తాం.
మంత్రులతో ఏమన్నా మాట్లాడటం జరిగిందా, లేకపోతే రాష్ట్రానికి సంబంధించి న్యాయం చేస్తామని చెప్పి మా వ్యాఖ్యలు ఏమైనా వచ్చాయా?
ఆ రకమైన హామీ కేంద్ర మంత్రుల్లోకి ఇచ్చినట్లయితే మనకి సమాచారం లేదు.
అయితే కాదు సార్, ప్రధానమంత్రి ఆహ్వానించారు కదా, ఆహ్వానించిన దాని మేరకు వెళ్తారా?
ఒకటేమంటే, ప్రధానమంత్రి గారు ఆహ్వానించారంటే రాజీనామాలు చేయకముందు మరి రమ్మని పిలిచిండొచ్చు, కానీ ఒకసారి నిర్ణయం జరిగిపోయింది. నిర్ణయం జరిగినాక మిత్రధర్మంగా సమాచారాన్ని అందించడానికి రాత్రి ప్రయత్నం చేశాను తప్ప ఇంకేదో ప్రధానమంత్రి గారు హామీ ఇస్తే మేము వెనక్కి తగ్గలనో నిర్ణయంలో మార్పు చేసుకోవాలనో కాదు. ఇప్పటికే చాలా ఓపిక్గా ఈ రాష్ట్ర ప్రయోజనాలు కాపాడుకోవాలి, అనాథగా మిగిలిన ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ రాష్ట్రానికి ఈరోజు అన్ని రకాలుగా అభివృద్ధి దిశగా ముందుకు తీసుకుపోతున్నాం, కేంద్రం కూడా తగినంత సహకారం అందిస్తే ఇంకా వేగంగా ఈ రాష్ట్రాన్ని అభివృద్ధి చేసుకోవాలనే ఒక తలంపుతో ఆశతో మనం ఇన్ని రోజులు కూడా వేచి చూడడం జరిగింది. మరి ఆశలు నెరవేరే మార్గాలు కనిపించినప్పుడు, అవకాశాలు లేనప్పుడు, ఆ రకమైన వాతావరణం లేనప్పుడు మనం తప్పనిసరి పరిస్థితుల్లో ఈ రకమైన నిర్ణయం తీసుకోవడం.
మోడీ గారు చంద్రబాబు నాయుడుకి మాట్లాడిన ఫోన్ సంభాషణలో ఏమన్నా రాష్ట్రానికి సంబంధించి హామీలు కావచ్చు, లేకపోతే ఈయన చెప్పినప్పుడు ఆయన రెస్పాండ్ కావడం, అటువంటిది ఏమైనా వచ్చింది?
పరిస్థితులు, నేపథ్యము, ఈ నిర్ణయానికి దారితీసిన పరిస్థితులు ఇవన్నీ కూడా వివరించినప్పుడు రండి కూర్చొని మాట్లాడుకుందామని చెప్పారు తప్ప ఇంకా వేరే.
సార్, ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ మోదీ కాల్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ అండ్ వాట్ వాస్ ద డిస్కషన్, ఇఫ్ యూ కెన్ షేర్ అండ్ యూ కెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ కెన్ బ్రీఫ్ మీడియా అబౌట్ ద డిస్కషన్, వాట్ డిస్కషన్ టుక్ ప్లేస్ అండ్ వెదర్ అట్ దిస్ మోమెంట్ వీ కెన్ సే బ్యాక్ ఛానల్ నెగోషియేషన్స్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ ఆన్ ఆర్ వాట్ పార్టీ హ్యాస్ కన్వేడ్ టు ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ అండ్ వాట్ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ హ్యాస్ కన్వేడ్ టు ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్?
యూ కాంట్ సీ దిస్ కాల్ యాజ్ ఎ నెగోషియేషన్. ద చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ కాల్ ది ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ యెస్టర్డే ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు ఇన్ఫార్మ్ that we are coming out of the government. The Prime Minister was not available, and he told the Chief Minister today that he returned home late last night, and in the morning he had to go to Rajasthan. So now he is free and he called the Chief Minister. And then he said, we can sit down and talk. Then the Honorable Chief Minister has said that we called yesterday in order to tell you as a courtesy that we are quitting the government because we waited for quite long. We waited for 4 years and our demands are very clear. We have been reiterating our demands time and again and nothing positive has come about. And the Prime Minister then said we have done something. Then the Honorable Chief Minister had said that, well, you have done something but not the substantive issues. Substantive issues are the special category status, the industrial incentives, the tax incentives, Polavaram project, the reimbursement, and the railway zone, and the steel factory, the petrochemical industry, and the port, and such other things. And the most of the institutions are also not really taking off. So there are several issues, and the sentiment in Andhra Pradesh is very high. The people are very angry. So we had to take a political call on this. Since the Honorable Finance Minister yesterday in the evening, he had made it clear that special category status is not possible, and they were limiting it to only the EAP projects of 90 and 10, 90% to 10%, which is not acceptable to us. So we have taken a decision. Our ministers would come and meet you and they will submit their resignations. This was the response of the Chief Minister.
Sir, was there any attempt by the Prime Minister to appease the Chief Minister and try to ask him to rethink about his decision?
No, that is what the Prime Minister had said initially, that, you know, let us sit and talk and sort it out. But then we have, the Honorable Chief Minister, as I told you, he said that we have waited for quite a long time, 4 years, and it is not possible anymore, especially after the Union Finance Minister's statement to the media.
You see this conversation between both the heads, state head as well as the central government head, a fruitful conversation, we can say the conversation was fruitful?
You see, what I told you is, what was the conversation between the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister? And I have given you as much information as possible on that.
So now, the issue is now, level where there is no return, it has reached that level.
Is there still a possibility to... The demand stands. It is for the Union government to respond to the demand. We have said this time and again, as we already told you, the Chief Minister has visited Delhi 29 times and met everybody possible, including the Prime Minister. On January 12th, before the budget, the Honorable Chief Minister had given a comprehensive memorandum to the Prime Minister. So the ball now is in the Union government's court.
So what
the Honorable Chief Minister had said, that, you know, we have come out of the government because we did not see a point in continuing the government. But we are part of NDA. We can still have a dialogue, we can still talk, and if there is anything that you can do to the state of Andhra Pradesh, you can very well do it, absolutely no problem at all.
So we saw this as step number one. What is the further course of action? Because the CM said we would be proceeding in steps.
Who said step number one?
He said we would be proceeding in steps.
You can't put words into anybody's mouth. This was step number one.
Almost over 20 days time.
First step in resign to...
Yeah, he said that, sir.
No, it's not first step. This is the step that we have taken now.
Prabhakar Garu, still 20 days of Parliament's session is left. There is a strong buzz that Center may come out and announce on the floor of the House, both the Houses, Finance Minister or any of the prominent Minister, may announce some kind of goodies or package for the state, whether it's a Vishakhapatnam Railway Zone or a steel plant in Kadapa or any other demand which you have made or you have put forward. Then what will be your reaction?
We'll be very happy. This is exactly what we wanted. We wanted steel plant, we wanted petrochemical industry, we want railway zone, we want special category status, we want port, we want all the institutions. This is our demand. We will be very happy. In fact, this is precisely what we wanted, precisely what we have been asking for.
And yes. Your party ministers have submitted the resignation. Has the resignation been accepted, sir? And what about the local ministers here?
The BJP ministers' resignation has been just accepted. We've just got the information, and we are not yet aware of the union ministers' resignations.
They have spoken on the telephone. And what will be the further action, sir? Because still the session is on. Now, apart from now, both the minister, MPs are now not ministers. So they will be also participating in the protest.
Of course, now because they are members of parliament, they are much more free to press the demands for the special category status and other demands.
Has anyone from the BJP side or the Prime Minister requested that TDP should not stall parliament, because already one half of the session was washed away because of these kind of protests only. This session is also witnessing a similar kind of protest. Prime Minister has talked
from... No, we spoke, I mean the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister have spoken only about the demands and the resignation letters of the decision of to resign from the union government.
Was there anything concrete that was promised by the Prime Minister during that phone call between the Prime Minister?
I told you everything that has happened between the Prime Minister and the Chief Minister.
There's no promises?
I've told you everything. I mean, you find out if there's anything.
In coming days, sir, we can see Chief Minister visiting to Delhi, probably meeting Prime Minister. Possible?
Well, today we are limiting ourselves to what has happened between the Chief Minister and the Prime Minister. I have given you a very comprehensive brief about what has happened, the conversation.
But you are not denying any possible meeting?
No, a Chief Minister and a Prime Minister, they keep meeting. I mean, he is the head of the Union Government and he is head of the State Government.
So pulling out of the Ministry and being part of the NDA, don't you think that this is a contradictory stand?
No, it's not. It's not. You see, I do not know. I do not know if you are aware of the NDA 1. NDA 1, although our party had 29 members of parliament, we were not part of the government. We were not in the ministry. We never asked for a ministry. This time, in fact, we have accepted ministerial positions in the union government, mainly, if not exclusively, in order to serve the interests of the state, because this is an infant state. It's a new state. And a state which is in difficulties. That is the reason why we joined the government this time. Earlier we did not join the government. Thank you.
Thank you. Sir.
Yes.